Hello everyone, my name is Titus and today we are going to discuss the topic collision in one dimension, that is head-on collision. Here we are going to derive expressions for the final velocities of two bodies after collision. Okay, so let us consider two bodies. Consider two bodies A and B of masses m1 and m2 respectively moving with velocities u1 and u2 along the same straight line. Where u1 is greater than u2. Let us illustrate this with the help of a diagram. So we have two bodies. This is body of mass m1 moving with velocity u1, and we have another body of mass m2 moving with velocity u2. This is before collision. Okay. Since here u1 is greater than u2, so they will collide after some time. So let the velocities be v1 and v2 of the bodies after collision. So for this also we will illustrate the diagram. This is mass m1, so now it is moving the velocity v1, and this is mass m2 moving the velocity v2. So here, so let v1 and v2 be the velocities of the bodies after collision. Okay. So then from Newton's law of collision we have. So then from Newton's law of collision we have, like we discussed in the previous class, v1 minus v2 divided by u1 minus u2 is equal to minus e, or where e is a coefficient of restitution. So now we can simplify this and we can write v1 minus v2 is equal to e times u2 minus u1. Okay. So let this be equation 1. Okay. So now applying principle of conservation of momentum. So applying principle of conservation of linear momentum. So the system of two masses, we have momentum before collision. Momentum before collision is equal to momentum after collision. And here we can write, so before collision the mass m1 has a momentum of m1 u1, mass m2 has a momentum of m2 u2, and after collision they will have momentum of m1 v1 plus m2 v2. Let us call this to be equation 2. So in equation 1 we have v1 minus v2 is equal to e times v2 minus u1 here. So let us multiply m2 to equation 1. So multiplying m2 to equation 1, we get m2 into v1 minus v2 is equal to e times m2 into u2 minus u1. Simplifying the equation further, we get m2 v1 minus m2 v2 is equal to m2 e times u2 minus m2 e times u1. Let us call this equation. Now adding equation 2 and 3. So adding equation 2 and 3, we get. So from equation 2 we have m1 u1 plus, sorry, let us m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. Let us reverse the equation. Let us write this as m2 v2 plus m1 v1 is equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2. And equation 3 we can write m2 v1 minus m2 v2 is equal to e times m2 u2 minus e times m2 u1. So adding both equation, if m2 v2 will cancel out, and we have v1 into m1 plus m2 is equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2 plus e times m2 u2 minus e times m2 u1. Simplifying this further, we have u1 into m1 minus e times m2 plus m2 u2 into 1 plus e, and on the left hand side we have v1 into m1 plus m2. From this we get v1 is equal to u1 into m1 minus e times m2 plus m2 u2 to 1 plus e whole divided by m1 plus m2. So this is the final velocity of mass m1 of a equation. So similarly, by multiplying m1 to equation 2 and solving like in this previous case, we can have v2 is equal to m1 u1 into 1 plus e plus u2 into m2 minus e times m1 whole divided by m1 plus m2. Let us call this equation 4 and this will be equation 5. So thus equation 4 and equation 5, they give us the expression for final velocity.